Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and explain about the electrical thermionic fundamental trainer. By this trainer kit, we will find out the thermionic work function of a tungsten wall and also verify the Richardson equation through the thermionic emission effect. So first, I will explain you what is the thermionic work function. So basically, thermionic work function is the minimum amount of thermal energy which is supplied to a metal to remove or eject an electron from it is called as a thermionic work function. So basically, Richardson is a scientist who gave the basic derivation and definitions of the and also find out the equation which is called as a Richardson relation. So we will verify the Richardson relation with the experiment, and we will now move on to the experiment setup, and I will explain you the different parts of about kit. So this is the basic kit which is used for electrical thermionic fundamental trainer. So this is the kit. The order code for this kit is 36293. You can check the specs and to queries, you can use this code through our website www.tesca.in. So I will explain you the different parts and different components about this kit. So this kit basically belongs the two supplies. There is IC regulated power supply for filament and there is IC regulated power supply for plates. So this is the basic experiment setup of Richardson experiment or the thermionic fundamental experiment. So in this, the filament works on the 0 to 5 volt at 3 amperes current range, and these are the knobs and positive negative terminal for the this voltage and this supply. So this is the coarse knob and this is the fine knob for the current and voltage, and this is the filament section. At this, the filament and the plate points are provided. This is the 2 and 8 filament points, and this is the 6th point which is connected with the plates. Now this is the supply for the plate which is to be charged. So this is the 0 to 60 volt AC power supply at 200 milliamperes, and this is also the coarse and fine knob for the adjustment of the supply, and positive and negative terminal to provide the supply. We are also providing voltmeters which is at 0 to 20 volts for measuring the filament voltage, and current meter 0 to 20 ampere for measuring the filament current as well. We are also using voltmeter 0 to 200 volts for the plate voltage, and 0 to 200 milliamperes current meter for the plate currents. So this is the last on off power switch. By this you can on and off this kit, and also a gel light will also glow when you on and off the kit. We are also providing user manual. In this user manual you will get the detailed theory and derivational explanations of the experiment, and we are offering some of the patch codes to do the electrical connections as given in the user manual. So you can study the whole derivation and thermionic fundamental in the user manual as well. So we will first discuss about the determination of thermionic work function of tungsten using a direct heated wall. So we will use the direct heated wall and a lamp at which we will directly heat the elements by the filament voltages and find out the thermionic work function using the voltmeters and current meters by taking down the reading at different values. Now we have to make this circuit diagram which is given in the user manual. So we will set up this circuit diagram on the kit, and after that we will find out the different readings and follow the calculation and the manual procedure. So we will first do the circuit connections as given in the user manual. So we will start with the 0 to 5 volts power supply as shown in the manual. So this will be first connected with voltmeter. So positive will be connected with positive and negative will be connected with negative. Now the voltmeter will also connected with the DPM for current. So positive will be connected with current, and the other end of this DPM is going to filaments terminal. So this is the first terminal of the filament. Now the other terminal, and we are also connect the 8 number terminal with the ground. We can use the black code instead of red for this. So we have connected the ground, the other end of the terminal. Now this terminal is also connecting with the plate supply. So this is the ground for both the plates and filament. So this is going to the voltmeter. Voltmeter's negative, and positive of this voltmeter is connected with the plate. But instead of using directly plate, we will fasten through this current ammeter. So this is the positive, which is going to the plate. Now we will add the supply for this. So positive will be connected with the positive of DPM, which is the voltmeter, and negative will be connected with the negative of the voltmeter or the ground. So 8 number terminal is grounded with both the supplies. Now we will verify our connections as per the user manual. Cross check your connections every time you do the experiments. So in case of any hazardous and safety purposes, you will do not damage the kit or any other sources. Now after verifying the connections, make sure all the knobs are at the zero positions. Now we will power on the circuit. Here you can see, if you find the voltmeter range is showing something volts, just increase the coarse knob and again decrease it. So it will discharge the plate voltage and the charged ions will be removed. So now all the readings at zero right now. Increase the filament voltage slowly and observe the thermionic function. Also you can note down the current in both the cases in some of the steps. So increase the current in 0.5 volts in steps of 0.5 volts and note down the simultaneous current, corresponding current at 1 volt. It is showing 1.7 amps, and at 2 volts it is showing 2.6 amps. So as you increase the current slowly, you will see the filament starts glowing. To see the proper lighting up of filaments, you will have to do this experiment in the dark room. So now I will increase some more current and you will see the filaments going glower. At this time the filaments starts glowing, that will consider as the draper point. At this point take the voltage and current and also find out the resistance using voltage and currents. Now I will just dim the light of the room so you can see the elements is glowing. Here you can see the element of the or the filament is glowing. At this time it start glowing. Take down the reading of voltage and current. This is the draper point, and as I decrease the voltage and current, you will see the filament will again glows off. Here you can see. Now I will increase the current again so you can see
how the filament is started glowing. Now I will increasing the supply so that you can see the filament starts glowing. Here you can see in the video. At this point you can take down the draper point readings as required in the manual and in the observation table.
Now at the draper point the voltage and currents need to be noted down in the observation table number 1. So VD and ID are the draper point current. You can calculate the resistance RD of the bulb filament at the draper point by using the RD equals to VD upon ID. Note down these values in the observation table, and you can also find out the VT and IT through the formulas given in the user manual by calculating the RR. Similarly, you can also find the RT and VT. Now at the draper point or at some of the value of voltage and current, you now can increase the plate voltage so you can find out the emission. So to take out the graph, to plot the graph, increase the voltage VP simultaneously and take readings at different steps of voltage and current. This is the plate voltage and plate current. So after taking some of the readings, note down it in the observation table number 2 given in the user manual. Also note down the at VT and VT of the filament voltage at which you have taken the readings of VP and IP. At some of the different voltage, again take some VP and IP readings. You will find out the graph of square root of VP and log of IP at x axis and y axis correspondingly. So the graph will be showing you at different temperatures like this. Now after taking the readings of different values like voltage and currents in the plate and as well filament, you can calculate the different values required in the experiment, and you can find out the thermionic work functions. Note down the thermionic work function of the filament in the electron volt in the result after calculating the calculations. Now we will do the second experiment. In the second experiment, verification of Richardson equation of thermionic emission is required. So for this you have to connect the same experiment as given in the experiment 1. All the connections are same, but in this you have to plot a graph between 1 by t and the log of I by t square by taking 1 by t along x axis and log e along y axis. So graph should be straight line as shown in figure 5. So this is the graph that you have get. So this graph you will get after taking, after calculating the readings and noting down the readings of different temperatures and different values. So this is the table 3 which is used to in experiment number 2. Same connections, same value and same procedure is required. So that's why I'm not explaining the whole functions. And after this you can calculate the different values which are required in the experiment. So the graph should be the straight line. If you find the straight line, that your verification of Richardson equation is cleared. So that was the experiment and the details about the kit, trainer kit of thermionic fundamental trainer. So by this kit you can find out, as I explained, that the thermionic work function of tungsten metal, and also you can verify the Richardson equations through the calculations. So while doing the experiment, if you find any difficulties, you can easily contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.